Greetings and welcome. Today we'll see the topic Jacobian of implicit function. Implicit function, that means if you are not able to separate the variable, that is known as implicit function. Suppose you have two implicit function f1 and f2 between the variables u, v, x, y. And if I want to find Jacobian of u, v with respect to x, y, since we have two functions, we'll multiply by the factor -1². If we have three functions, we'll multiply by the factor -1³. So it is -1² Jacobian of f1, f2. Whatever variable in the denominator, we will consider it in the numerator. And numerator cha variable, you have to consider it in the denominator. So we have the formula Jacobian of uv with respect to xy is equal to -1² Jacobian of f1, f2 with respect to xy upon Jacobian of f1, f2 with respect to uv. Similarly, suppose if you have three functions f1, f2, f3. Between the six variables u, v, w, x, y, z. And if I want Jacobian of u, v, w with respect to x, y, z, since we have three functions, we'll multiply by the factor -1³ Jacobian of f1, f2, f3 with respect to x, y, z upon Jacobian of f1, f2, f3 with respect to u, v, w. These are the formulas to find Jacobian of implicit function. Now if I take the example, say x is equal to v square plus w square, y is equal to w square plus u square, z is equal to u square plus v square. It is easy to find Jacobian of x, y, z with respect to u, v, w. We can use the property j into j dash equal to 1, or we can use this Jacobian of implicit function. We want here Jacobian of u, v, w with respect to x, y, z. If I write down the first function, say f1 is equal to v square plus w square minus x is equal to 0. Say f2 is equal to u square plus w square minus y equal to 0. Say the third function f3 is equal to u square plus v square minus z equal to 0. So we have three implicit relations between u, v, w, x, y, z. Now if I want Jacobian of u, v, w with respect to x, y, z, we have three functions, so we'll multiply by the factor -1³. Jacobian of f1, f2, f3 with respect to x, y, z upon Jacobian of f1, f2, f3 with respect to u, v, w. If we use the definition, -1³ is minus determinant of derivative of f1 with respect to x, with respect to y, and with respect to z. Similarly, f2x, f2y, f2z. Derivative of f3 with respect to x, f3 with respect to y, f3 with respect to z. Similarly, in the denominator, we have derivative of f1 with respect to u, v, and w. Second row will be derivative of f2 with respect to u, f2 with respect to v, f2 with respect to w. Third row will be derivative of f3 with respect to u, with respect to v, and with respect to w. Now we'll find the value. You have minus outside determinant of derivative of f1 with respect to x. It is -1. There is no y and z, so the derivatives will be 0. Similarly, derivative of f2 with respect to x is 0, f2 with respect to y is -1, and f2 with respect to z is 0. Derivative of f3 with respect to x is 0, y 0, z is -1. Upon determinant of derivative of f1 with respect to u, v, w. There is no u, so the derivative will be 0, 2v, 2w. Similarly, if I find derivative of f2 with respect to u, it is 2u. This is 0, 2w. Derivative of f3 with respect to u, it is 2u, 2v, and 0. If we expand this determinant, -1, -1 × -1 will be -1, and this minus sign will be 1. Upon what is common from the first column, it is 2u, second column it is 2v, third column it is 2w. If I take it outside, it is 8uvw into determinant of 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 110, and if we expand this determinant, you will get the value of determinant is 2, and your answer will be 1/16 UVW, and this is Jacobian of UVW with respect to XYZ. We'll take one more example. Now we'll take the another example, say x² + y² + u² - v² = 0, uv plus xy equal to 0, and we want to find Jacobian of uv with respect to xy. If I denote this as f1, say f1 is equal to x² + y² + u² - v² and this as f2, say f2 is equal to uv plus xy. We want to find Jacobian of uv with respect to xy. If you observe this, we have two functions, f1 and f2. So, we'll multiply by the factor -1². Jacobian of f1, f2 with respect to xy upon Jacobian of f1, f2 with respect to uv. Now, we'll use the definition of Jacobian. -1² is 1. So, you have in the numerator, it is determinant of f1 with respect to x, f1 with respect to y, f2 with respect to x, f2 with respect to y, upon, in the denominator, we have derivative of f1 with respect to u, f1 with respect to v, f2 with respect to u, f2 with respect to v, equal to, derivative of f1 with respect to x is 2x, derivative of f1 with respect to y is 2y. Derivative of f2 with respect to x is y. Derivative of f2 with respect to y is x upon determinant of derivative of f1 with respect to u, it is 2u. Derivative of f1 with respect to v is -2v. Derivative of f2 with respect to u is v. Derivative of f2 with respect to u is v is u. So you will get the answer. If we expand this determinant, it is 2x² - 2y². We can take 2 common. It is x² - y² upon, if we expand this determinant, 2 will take it outside. It is u² + v² and this 2 will get cancelled. This will give you Jacobian of uv with respect to xy. We'll take one more example. Now suppose if I want to find the Jacobian of uv with respect to xy, for x is equal to e^v sec u, y is equal to e^v tan u. There are two methods to solve this example. Some people will first find relation of u and v in terms of x and y, and then they will find Jacobian of uv with respect to xy. Or we can use the Jacobian of implicit function. If I transfer this plus x to the left hand side, it will become minus x. Say equal to 0. We denote this by f1 plus 5. If I transfer to the left hand side minus 1, say this as f2. So we have two relations. We want to find Jacobian of uv with respect to x1. Since we have two functions, we can write down -1² Jacobian of f1, f2. With respect to xy upon Jacobian of f1, f2 with respect to uv. So this is equation number 1. We'll find value of numerator and denominator. If you want, you can find it separately or directly also. If I'll find numerator, it is derivative of f1 with respect to x, derivative of f1 with respect to y, f2 with respect to x, f2 with respect to y. If I differentiate this with respect to x, it is -1. With respect to y, there is no y, so the value will be 0. Derivative of f2 with respect to x, there is no x, so the value is 0. With respect to y, it is -1. So you have value of numerator is 1. Now if I find value of denominator, that is equal to derivative of f1 with respect to u and derivative of f1 partially with respect to v, f2 with respect to u and f2 with respect to v, that is equal to determinant of derivative of f1 with respect to u. Derivative of sec u is sec u tan u. So it is e raised to v sec u into tan u. Derivative of f1 with respect to v. Derivative of v e raised to v is e raised to v. So it is e raised to v sec u as it is. Derivative of f2 with respect to u. Derivative of tan u is sec square u. So it is e raised to v sec square u. Derivative of f2 with respect to v is e raised to v tan u. Now we use the property of determinant that if there is something common from the row or column, we can take it outside the determinant. If you observe this, if I take e raised to v sec u common from the first row, it is e raised to v sec u. Similarly, from the second row, we can take e raised to v common. So it is e raised to v in the determinant. What is remaining? Tan u 1 sec square u and tan u. If we solve this determinant, you will get e raised to 2v into sec u tan square u minus sec square u. And value of tan square u minus sec square u is minus 1. So you will get the value minus e raised to 2v sec u. This is value of denominator. We will substitute value of numerator and denominator in equation 1. And you will get Jacobian of uv with respect to xy equal to 1 upon minus e raised to 2v into sec u. This is Jacobian of uv with respect to xy. We can find, we can take one more example. Say x plus y plus z equal to u. Y plus z equal to uv and z equal to uvw. Z is equal to uvw into v into w. And if I want Jacobian of uvw, okay, I can say Jacobian of xyz with respect to uvw. So first we'll write down the function. If I transfer this plus u to the left hand side, it is minus u. Say this as f1. So what is your f2? F2 will be equal to y plus z minus uv equal to 0. And we can say f3 is equal to z minus uvw equal to 0. If I denote this as f1, f2, f3. And if we use the formula Jacobian of xyz, how many functions we have? 3 functions. So we'll multiply by the factor minus 1 cube Jacobian of f1, f2, f3 with respect to Jacobian of f1, f2, f3 with respect to whatever variable in the denominator, we'll consider it in the numerator u, v, w, and in the numerator's variable we'll consider it in the denominator, that is x, y, z. Say this as equation number 1. Now if I find value of numerator, that is derivative of f1 with respect to u, v and w. Derivative of f2 with respect to u, v and w. Derivative of f3 with respect to v, u, v and w. Equal to determinant of. Derivative of f1 with respect to u is minus 1. With respect to v, it is 0 because there is no v in f1. W, it is 0. So it is 0, 0. Derivative of f2 with respect to u. This is 0, this is 0. You will get minus v, minus u. There is no w, so the value will be 0. Derivative of f3 with respect to u is minus vw. With respect to v, it is minus uw. And with respect to w, the value is minus uv. If you observe this determinant, this is lower triangular determinant. And value of the lower triangular is nothing but multiplication of this diagonal element. So only you have to take multiplication of this. You will get minus minus plus and this minus sign. That is minus u square v. This is numerator. Now we will try to find value of denominator. That is determinant of derivative of f1 with respect to x, f1 with respect to y, f1 with respect to z, Second row is f2 with respect to x, f2 with respect to y, f2 with respect to z, f3 with respect to x, y and z, derivatives of f3. If I find the value, derivative of f1 with respect to x is 1, with respect to y is 1, with respect to z is 1. Derivative of f2 with respect to x, there is no x, so the derivative is 0. With respect to y, the value is 1. With respect to z, the value is 1. Derivative of f3 with respect to x, 0, y, 0, z, 1. Again, if you observe this, this is upper triangular matrix, determinant. So, value of the determinant is 1. Now, if you substitute these values in equation 1, you will get Jacobian of x, y, z with respect to u, v, w. Equal to minus 1 cube is minus 1. Numerator ची वैल्यू है minus u square v upon denominator is 1. So your answer is u square v. This is Jacobian of x, y, z with respect to u, v, w. Thank you.